everybody. How are you doing? We are here on a Saturday doing a very cool little special webinar for you guys. So this is going to be a little different than one of our normal webinars that we do for teaching. For those of you that are in the EAT community, the Economic Action Team community, if you're not in that, then this will be all new to you. But if you are, this is a different platform, as you can see. There's things about it that we really like. There's other things that are not quite as nice. That is why we're going to continue to use our GoToWebinar platform for all of our teaching. But this is going to be special today. I'm going to teach about an amazing topic, how you can be healthier, happier, and leave a legacy. And if you could, if you've got a problem, if this ever sort of breaks up on you, just refresh. Just click that little thing on your browser that allows you to refresh, and that'll bring you back in. This takes a little bit more bandwidth than our normal GoToWebinar platform does. But there's things about it that we really like, and I think you're going to understand that as you see. And in about 30 seconds here, I'm going to switch over to slides, and you're not going to be seeing the webcam anymore. And I'll ask you in the chat if you would just indicate that you're seeing things. If you've got questions, go ahead and be asking them. Noah said something about your messages are repeating. I'm not really sure what that means. What you're seeing over in the chat is people that are just saying where they're at. We've got Jillian in Toronto and all kinds of other places. There's people right now, I think, from five or six continents that are on here and all over. Mark from Bluffton in Ohio. Just put on there where you're from. That chat area over there is for you guys to talk to each other and to give questions. You'll notice that there's something to where you can put a little color. I think you can click on the little check, and that'll make your comment a question. And Deb is helping me here as an admin. Deb, why don't you put a little message in there, because I think you'll show up as an admin then. And I'll probably answer questions near the end here. So that's going to be kind of the sequence. I'm going to give you about 35 minutes of 40 minutes of some really cool teaching, tell you just a little bit about me. Some of you know that already, but others don't. And us, the Institute of Economics and the Economic Action Team, and some of the things that we're doing. And then if I get your permission, and I'll ask for it at the time, I'm going to do about a 10-minute little offer that I'm going to give you, something that's really special, some freebies, some other really cool stuff. And Deb, you're not showing up as an admin, so that's all right. And I don't know if I know how to make you one, actually. So we had a little bit of a challenge. We're not figuring out exactly how to get our folks in as admins. And we've got Leo that just came in from Italy. And we've got Cloudy Millington, Michigan in here. So anyway, I'm going to go ahead and get started. I'm going to switch to my slides. So I'm going to turn on the screen share here. This is going to be a webinar of 5 keys to be able to make you healthier and happier, and to leave a legacy that you're going to be proud of. And Leslie says, it's snowing here. She's in Spain, and the weather's been nice at times, and the internet's not perfect. So anyway, and you guys should be able, one of the things that's different about this system than what we usually use with GoToWebinar is you'll see the chat on there from everybody. So you can just kind of interact with each other. They say that the best kind of a webinar is when people are moving their fingers and moving around. So I want you to interact as you go. So this is going to, again, I'm going to teach you about some what I think are really important keys. This is not going to be technical. And then we're going to talk a little bit of what we call an offer near the end of this. A lot of you know me and some of you don't. And I'm Wayne Dorband here and representing the Institute of Economics and the Economic Action Team. And that we abbreviate as EAT. And those are just a couple of pictures of me, one of them in a laboratory and a greenhouse situation that we have. And there's me in my house. So we'll talk more about me as we go along here a little bit. But how would you like to learn how to exponentially increase the joy in your life while also creating legacy for the future? Throw some ones in there if that's something that's important to you. You think you'd like that? You think you'd like to find out how maybe you can have a little more joy and then also create a legacy? I think almost I certainly would. We live in a time where people want to achieve value in their lives, and they want to do it by helping people and making the planet better. A bunch of ones there from everybody saying that, yeah, that's something they'd like to do. So we call this a colonomic living, living in a time where people want to achieve value in their lives by making people on the planet better. So what is that weird word, ecolonomics? It is the synergy in between ecology and economy. And you'll see in that little picture, it shows that. And society also. So again, pronounced ecolonomics. A lot of times people go ecolo and it's ecolonomics. The word ecolonomics was created by the renowned earth activist and actor Dennis Weaver in the 1990s. So now that you see his picture here, who knows what of some of the famous shows and things that Dennis Weaver in. Put a guess up on the screen if you know what there were. There were a couple of them that he did. That it is the best word to use to describe the true essence of all the terms used to describe making the planet better. Those words like regenerative, restorative, holistic, sustainable, green. We've chosen to use the word ecolonomics. So it's kind of interesting. We're living in a very different time on the earth today, in a whole different era. If you look at a timeline throughout time and look at it related to people and the way that they lived way back in time and probably thousands of years ago, hunters and gatherers were what were the dominant type of person. And they were doing either hunting and gathering or beginning to do family farming. And they were doing it in a balance with nature. And they did it for a long time in that way. Literally up until about 200 or 300 years ago, most local farming and commerce was done in a very balanced way with nature. But about 200 years ago, local farming and commerce began to degrade the planet to some extent. And when industry started to occur, then we started to see mass destruction of ecosystems because of farming and because of land use activities. But you know what? I think we live in a whole different time. I think we live in a time where people want to have regenerative living. They want to be able to farm in a regenerative way, and they want to have industry. And I don't think you'd be here unless that was something that you were interested in. And we call that ecolonomics. So in this new ecolonomic era, there are going to be lots of winners and there's going to be lots of losers. So let's talk about what the winners are going to be doing. They're going to be people that have a triple bottom line mentality. They're going to think about profit, people, and the planet. They're going to live with appropriate living standards, not too much, not too little. They, and I put in here we, because I think all of us on here feel this way, we are stewards or managers of the earth, and our job is to preserve it and enhance it for future generations. I happen to believe that you guys believe that. I certainly do. What about the losers? What are these people thinking? Most of them just want more profit for their shareholders today. They want personal gain first, and then if possible, maybe gain for others, maybe not. And frankly, they only think that most people and other things on the earth are there for their own benefit. So what's the common thread among all the winners? I think they're finding ways to embrace the ecolonomic era. So let's talk about how you can do that also. So let's set a game plan for this webinar. It's going to be about an hour in length. If you would, this is really going to be important stuff. We're all spending our important, valuable time here. If you can, eliminate distractions, turn off your phone, close other tabs, turn off the TV, all that kind of stuff. That'll be great. Marvin says his screen says he can't view the webinar in restricted mode. This is our first. I'm not sure what that means. Marvin, a whole bunch of other folks are able to view it. I don't know what's going on with you there. So sorry, but I got to keep moving here. So, but we'll see if maybe some of our staff can help you figure that one out. So I'm going to teach you about how you can be a winner in this new ecolonomic era for about 35 minutes. I'm going to show you some direct evidence about others like you that are benefiting now And then if you don't mind, I'm going to present you with about a 10-minute video or portion of the video that's an offer that we have to create a legacy as a winner yourself and a value adder. Some of you have already taken advantage of this. The presentation, please throw in questions and comments in the chat. I'll either answer them at the time, just like I did with Marvin just a second ago, or I'll answer them in a Q&A at the end, or we've got some staff that'll help you also. So I hope people are helping you, Marvin, with the screen issue. If you stay to the end, I've got a couple of bonuses that I'll get for you. And they're going to be pretty cool. So here's an interesting one. People know that we have spent thousands of years and billions of dollars screwing up the planet. And I didn't see it, but I meant to put the E on that "the." I didn't mean to fade right in, but that's a kind of an interesting drawing. There's aerosol spray, which is what a lot of people think is what's causing some of our climate change to be occurring. We know that natural resources are finite and won't be there for future generations. Who can tell me what that picture is over on the right? Kind of looks like a forest fire, but that's not what it is. What if it isn't that? It's actually a clear cut. I don't know about you, but a lot of us are sick and tired of getting our food from thousands of miles away. And if you don't know it, that's the reality. Most food in the United States and throughout the world comes from 1,500 miles to 2,000 miles away. Clean water for drinking is not available to more than a billion people on the planet. I hope that's not any of you, but it probably is somebody close to you. Our land management practices are degrading land so fast that it appears we really don't even care. And some people might say this is deniable, but climate change is undeniable. And frankly, it's as little as 20 years and the consequences are going to be catastrophic. And I could go on with a lot more, but let me give you just a couple of really specific issues. For the losers, there is less than 4 days of food available in any major city in the world if transportation from the outside was stopped. That's a fact. If those trucks or trains or planes that bring food to a major city anywhere in the world get cut off, in 4 days, there's going to be rioting in the streets. People are going to start killing each other for food. We're losing 200 square kilometers of forest a day to degrading land use. This is 2015 statistics. That's 36,000 acres in US numbers. And this one is also one that you're hearing people talk a lot more about now. Here in the United States, in less than 30 years, we're not going to have enough water from the aquifers in the central part of our country, Oklahoma, Kansas, Nebraska, Iowa, the grain belt, to produce the corn and wheat needed to feed the nation. Now, there would be those of us that would argue we don't need it for that purpose because it's not even being used to feed the nation, but we're not going to be able to grow anything in those areas. Leslie says we have rainwater right now. So here's what I'm going to go into teaching you guys something. I think this is going to be fun. I'm going to teach you about 5 simple life keys that you can use to increase joy in your life today and create a legacy for the future. So here's goes. Buckle up. I'm going to go kind of fast. So here's key number 1. You have to make a mental and emotional shift commitment that you will not define your success by these things that I'm going to put right here. You shouldn't define your success by the income you earn, by the wealth you accumulate, the stuff or toys that you have, or the status you achieve. Instead, what if you valued your self-worth by the true friends you make, your physical, mental, spiritual, and emotional health, being balanced? How about the help you give to those in need? And finally, how about the impact you have on enhancing the quality of life on this earth for generations to come? So that's key number one. How about key number two? You are never stagnant in your life. You're either going backward or you're moving forward. So these are just kind of graphic pictures. There's a stagnant pond, a dog that's probably dying, and a river flowing forward. You're never stagnant. You're either moving forward or you're moving backward. Key number three. By the way, you probably should recognize some of those people on the right, the picture. You are today the average of the five people you spend the most time with. You probably heard that, but you think about it very much. And you will become 5 years from now a product of what you are reading, watching, and hearing today. Number four, you are either a dream maker or a dream stealer. Key number five, anything you do to make people and the planet better will make you healthier and happier today and create a legacy for you over time and even after you pass on. All right, so now let's break those five down, those five keys, and let's see how specifically you can apply them in your life. So remember, key number one, just going to go quickly over it. No, it was shifting your values. I want you to learn a little bit more about Deb and I and our businesses because it's relevant because you all have your own story and there's probably some things in your story that can come from mine. I grew up happy with stable depression-era parents. Yeah, I'm 64 years old. And I was highly focused on financial stability. My parents were. They wanted something for their child, their next generation to be better. They were the greatest generation, and they wanted the next generation to be better. Personally, I was highly competitive. I was entrepreneurial. And I was taught and mentored to achieve financial independence. That was what I was really taught. You need to achieve financial independence, and not just for yourself, but for your kids, for your grandkids. That was what I learned. I had a spiritual belief, and one of those was that I deserved to be financially successful. And for most of my life, I lived that way. I thought, you know what? I'm a decent person. I deserve to be financially successful. I really should try to achieve financial independence. And you know what? I had about 35 years when there was a pretty good run of success. Had wonderful children, no big health challenges. Deb is the most amazing person in the world, and my wife, and just couldn't ask for any more. We had financial success. We had a number of businesses that were working well. Had our setbacks, like everybody does, but it really went really pretty well for a long time. Guess what? 2008, 2009 came and our financial world came crashing down. There's a whole story here. I'm not going to go into the details, but basically we came to a point where we got mentally and emotionally ready to lose everything, to lose all our assets. Between 2012 and 2013, everything we'd worked for financially for 35 years to accumulate was gone. Except there's some little nuances in the laws in the United States. We didn't lose our farm. And what's interesting, nobody wanted our animals. They literally thought that there's this old adage of it's called dead. If they die, eat, or dump, we don't want to have anything to do with them. So we didn't lose those. And because of that, the important things, which were people and the land and those animals that were in our lives, we gained a huge closeness to friends and family. Today, we really don't have any interests in financial gain. Our attitude is way more that it's important to really don't think about owning anything. We really don't. And that we're really just stewards of anything we have. And we're there to manage it. reality is we're so much more healthy, happy, and joyous. So I tell that story because it might, there might be bits and pieces of it that apply to you. Maybe, maybe not. For us, it took a financial crisis to cause the change, but it's been dramatic and it's been wonderful. And honestly, it's why what we were motivated to do to start this whole Colonomic Action Team, to initiate our program called IDEA, which is the International Drive for Colonomic Action, and to move forward with what is called the Best of the Best program and the Hope for the Hopeless. And those are things you'll hear more and more about. But I want to just tell one brief little story here as it relates to that. And it happened about 6 or 7 years ago. But it took the financial crisis that happened after that to really move us ahead. And that was that I was at a leadership conference where there were some of the top leaders in the world. One of the speakers was Tony Blair, who used to be the Prime Minister of England. Another speaker was Jack Welch, who used to be the chairman of the board and CEO of General Electric. And amazing speakers. And on the second day, it was a two-day conference right before lunch. A guy got up to speak from Ghana, and the room had thousands of people in it. And this guy was not a good speaker. Don't remember his name even. And he was boring and you couldn't understand him very well. Well, about 30 minutes into his 45-minute talk, about a third of the people in that room had left, kind of slowly gotten up and gotten out. With about 5 minutes left, I was ready to leave, and I had actually stood up when all of a sudden this guy went, and I don't know if you heard that, but I whacked on the desk that my microphone is on because he hit on the lectern, the podium that he was on. And I'm this a little bit, but he said, "You white people." And when you looked around the room, that's what most of us were. "You've been coming to my country for 400 years and giving us food. And we're still starving. Stop giving us fish. Teach us to fish." And it was like he dug a dagger into my heart. Because I've been on a bunch of trips where I've gone to help people by giving them food in places where people are hungry. I've done the 10-mile mountaintop experiences. But I hadn't really done a lot to empower, to help people like he's talking about. But he wasn't done. He stopped and he hesitated for just a little bit and then he continued. "Because we have just as many natural resources as you do." And I thought about it, and that's true. They really do. But we don't think about it that way. And then he went on and said, "And we're just as smart as you are." And that was really tough. Because you know what? If I really admitted it to myself, I didn't believe that. I thought the culture were way smarter. That's why we were not hungry. That's why we didn't have the problems. But he was so right. Then he finished. And he said, "Please stop entitling us. Empower us. Teach us to feed ourselves. Don't give us a fish. Teach us the fish stage." Well, that talk and a bunch of other things, but mainly that talk, is the most impactful of any that I've ever had in my life. And it's what motivated us to start this IDEA, the International Drive for Colonomic Excellence, the Hope for the Hopeless plan, which is to help people in places in the world where they are hungry, not by going in and giving them food, but by going in and teaching them how to build appropriate systems for their lives and to do things that will provide food for generations to come. Use the techniques, use the method for their area, use the kinds of foods that are appropriate, all the things that we're teaching through the Colonomic Action Team. And I know many of you are very interested in. So now moving on and talking a little bit about others. So I want to stop just quickly. if any of that hits you guys, if it touches any of you, use your fingers a little bit and maybe share a little bit about that in the chat for others that are on here, and put a one in if that meant anything to you about how something you can do, not necessarily this story, that's mine. You need to have your own. But here's one that's interesting. There are 5 what are called blue zone communities around the world where a significant portion of the population lives to be over 100, and they live happy and healthy lives. Why is that? Why is it there are these 5 places? Well, what are they first? Well, one of them is in Sardinia, Italy. Another one's in the islands of Okinawa. By the way, thank you guys for all the ones. And thank you thanks for the story. I am breaking up just a little bit. It does really touch me that we're not doing what we need to teach people how to feed themselves. So that's what we want to do. But anyway, back to the 5 blue zone communities. Sardinia, Italy, the islands of Okinawa, Japan, Loma Linda, California, Nicoya, Costa Rica, Ikaria, Greece. These are places where there's all kinds of evidence and been many, many studies of them now through the years that show that people will live to be older, they'll live to be more happy, and they'll be more healthy. What do these places have in common? And this is really just on the surface. You guys should study these places more. There's lots of information, and we'll help you get it if you'd like to. First is there's little or no cancer, little or none. There's an intense importance of community. These are people that love to be with the people around them. They don't just text message all the time and sit and looking at their phones. They have highly plant-based diets. They're not vegetarians totally, but they truly understand the importance of plants in a big way in their diets. They do moderate daily exercise. They don't go crazy. It's not like they're workout nuts, but they're always moving. They don't sit very often. They're getting moderate exercise all the time. And here's a real interesting one. Most of them work in the dirt in some way. They're either farmers. A lot of these are farming cultures. Actually, all of them, but Loma Linda, are specifically farming cultures. But even when it's not in the culture, they're getting themselves dirty. They're working on the planet and in the earth. So how about for you? What have you seen in your own lives, those around you? Again, I said it earlier, but the Ekonomic Living embraces all these values that these people have and the ones that this fellow from Ghana imparted to me. And there is a revolution occurring with people making these shifts. So what are some things that you can do to make these value shifts? 1, you can take advantage of your free EAT membership. If you're registering for this for the first time, you are now going to be, and this is one of the bonuses, you're going to be a member, a free member of our EAT community. And there's all kinds of things that value you can get than that. 15 hours a week right now of live presentations from experts from all over the world where you're in an intimate setting. It's like being in a college classroom with them. And then potentially the value of getting additional information from them with some limited replays and other things. You don't have any membership in a meetup group, and I don't care where you're at in the world, there are these meetup groups. And meetup groups, that's a term that's kind of like handkerchiefs now or band-aids, but that's a formal kind of a group. There is a online entity called Meetup. That's why if you don't have one that's in an area you're interested in, like a topic, so if you're interested in beekeeping, join a beekeeping meetup or create one yourself. You can just, it's easy, it's free. You can set them up yourself. And we can help you do that. We have several of them. We have one here called the Birth at Urban Farm. We have one called Northern Colorado Sustainable Farming and Ranching that are just where we get together and we meet on somewhat of a regular basis. Develop a budget for your family that's not dependent on wealth building and stuff accumulation. Wouldn't that be interesting? See if you think you could do it. Make a trip to go visit someone you know who has made this shift and see how they're living. You can come and visit us. We've made the shift. We'd love to have you. As you do that, be critical and see if it could work for you. Start with little changes and see how they feel, and then make more and more. You've heard the old saying, how do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time. Find books, videos, podcasts, all kinds of things that can engage you with what you want to learn about, those topics that are interesting to you, those shifting of values. You can get more and more knowledge about how you might make this shift. I'm going to talk about this more later, but Elite Eat could provide you with that. And then find a planet-changing organization to which you can donate time and money. There's all kinds of them. I know Leslie, who's on here, is hugely interested in supporting climate change initiatives to reduce climate change. There's a lot of you. I could just call out names of people that I know are here, that you guys care about that. That's important to you. So now let's go into key number two. You're never stagnant in your life. You're either moving forward or backward, excuse me, or you're moving forward. You always want to be moving forward. Think about this fact and live it minute to minute. So here's the things I wanted you to do. Don't worry about it a year from now. Don't worry about it 6 months. Do it right now. This minute. Live this minute like you're moving forward. Don't worry about what you did a minute ago. Do it right now. You can't change the past, but you can learn from it. I hear people say sometimes, I don't care about the past. Well, but remember it so you can learn from it. Make everything that you do the best you can do. A lot of us, and I've been guilty of this, talk about, oh, I can multitask. I can do a whole bunch of things at once really well. Well, it's been proven pretty well through brain research and physiology and such that we can't do that. You really only can do one thing at a time. And you might do that for 10 minutes and do another thing for another 10 and so on. But you, when you're doing that, do it the best you can do it. Dream big and dream big dreams. And this is related to the key number five. And then work to achieve them in all you do. And you're not going to reach all of them, but always be working that way. Don't be frustrated by failing. There's actually nothing wrong with failing. You can learn from it. Just try not to fail totally. So failing just means that you're making mistakes. Failure is quitting. So I wondered if you figured out who that guy is on the picture here. That's Thomas Edison. And Thomas Edison said, I didn't invent the light bulb. I just found 9,999 ways not to invent it. And I got lucky one time. So he didn't get frustrated by failing. He kept failing and failing, and finally he succeeded. And whenever you find yourself slipping backward, find the action that best energizes you and do it. And that's different for all of us. Maybe for some of you, it's meditation. Others, it's exercise, reading, hanging out with friends, being alone, building something, working in the dirt. Find what energizes you when you, anytime you find yourself slipping backward, and do it. This is a cool one. You are today the average of the five people you spend the most time with, and you'll become 5 years from now a product of what you're reading, watching, and hearing. So have you heard these before? I'm going to put a little poll up here on the chat. If I can move my cursor. Here we go. Let's see if you guys can put some answers into this. And that is, do you believe it? So load this up. And do you believe you are the, so I'm just putting it up there. The poll is running. So let's just see what it does. I'm going to follow it here for a second. So have you heard these two keys or laws before? Probably a lot of you have, but some maybe haven't. Live them. Or are you in denial about them? Are the five people you spend the most time with pretty negative and you just don't want to admit it? What are you reading, hearing, watching? Is it TV, news, novels? Nothing wrong with those things, but guess what? That's what you're spending most of your time doing. That's what you're going to be many years from now. Things you can do to make this powerful key number three work for you. One, take advantage of the power of this digital technology that we're on right now. and connect with people through forums, social media pages, programs like EAT, ours, and others. You'll be able to spend virtual time with these amazing people. By the way, on our survey right now, it's 93% yes and 7% no. We'll just watch it for a little bit here and see what the final outcome is. Here's an interesting one. And we've got two or three of them on the line here with us right now. Hire a part-time virtual assistant somewhere else in the world, even, who is sharp. Arib, who's on here right now with us, is amazing guy. I hope you get to know him better. He works in the middle of the night for us. He plays rugby during the day and has been on the rugby national team in Pakistan. He's in an MBA program. This guy works 16, 18 hours a day, not because he has to, because he wants to. By the way, our percentages went down a little bit. It's now 88% yes and 12% no. So somebody, some other no. So don't necessarily believe that you're the average of the people. So, but this is something you ought to try. And again, talk to us about it here at EAT if it's something that you want to think about. You can do it really easily, a lot easier than you think. Get involved with a private mastermind group. What are mastermind groups? They're groups of people that have topics, ideas that they're interested in. EAT is a mastermind group, by the way. And hang out with those people and do it regularly. Coaching and mentoring. So guess what? I'm going to put one more poll up. So we ended up 88% yes, 12% no. And we're going to do another one here. I got to reset it. So I'm going to do a second one, which is, do you have a mentor in your life? So we're going to start that poll. So just answer yes or no. Do you know what a mentor is? So a mentor is someone who you ask to help you and to be completely accountable to. In other words, somebody that you are willing to bear your entire soul to, and you realize they're not going to share it with anybody else. And when you do that, they're perfectly honest with you and they'll tell you, even if it's somewhat negative, you need to be doing something different. Highly recommend you think about that. And again, it's up to you. Mentors aren't going to come to you and say, I will mentor you. You need to go to them and ask for mentoring. And it could be a person your age, a person in your field, a person just you that you respect. It can be anybody, but we all need to have mentors. So right now, that poll, we've got a 40% yes, 43 now, 57 no. So people are still answering it. Join local networking groups. And I've talked about meetups, but here's another one. Business Networking International. Almost all of major cities in the world have this group called BNI. And they hold breakfast meetings and different times of the day. And they're free. And you can just show up. And it's a place to network, interact with other people. Join chambers of commerce. Private entities, social groups like the Rotary Club or others. Just getting involved in groups that are networking groups at a local level. I'll leave the survey up for just a minute. Seek out an expert for the topic that is your passion and create a relationship. This is another interesting one. You need to make the effort. Again, if you're a member here of EAT, reach out to people like Mark. Put yourself out there. If Mark Shepherd is somebody you want to interact with, could be Mark B, by the way, who's one of our helpers also, and my assistants from Bangladesh. Maybe you want to get a topic expert, something from Mark. But you have to do it. It's your responsibility. Don't leave it to somebody else. How about key number four? You're either a dream maker or a dream stealer. Be a dream maker. Always be creating your own dreams and goals and encourage others to follow theirs. So it looks like we finished up this poll and it's 57% said no and 43% yes. And I could ask another question. I'm not going to do it here, but could it just been, well, if you don't have one, would you like one? And maybe we could help people and to get to that if that's something that they like. So always be creating your own dreams and goals. And here's the big one, not just yours, encourage others to follow theirs. Okay. That's important also. Be a big time encourager. It's so easy to subconsciously be a dream stealer. Never be negative about someone else's dream, no matter what it is. It doesn't have to be yours. It just be positive about it. So what are some things you can do to be a better dream maker? You can take time to listen to inspiring talks through things like TED Talks, TEDx, YouTube, others. Make it a priority to write down any dreams you have. Keep a journal of your thoughts about your dreams and those people. Again, not just yours, but keep a journal of those that are people that are around you so you can help them. The practices of key number three, which is be like the five people you're going to be around the most and those things that you're reading. Use that to help create better relationships and get away from dream stealers. If there's a dream stealer in your life, get away from them. And finally, key number five, anything you do to make people on the planet better will make you healthier and happier today and create a legacy for you over time and even after you pass on. So what can you do about that? Obviously, we're pretty greatly biased about this key number five. We have evidence in our own lives, this is Deb and I, and in hundreds of others from comments that we've received from members of the community. People want to have earth-friendly lifestyles, and they know they'll have long-term legacy impacts. So what can you do to use this key number five? You have to think about quitting your job. You don't need to move off-grid and start farming. I mean, that would be great, but you can achieve this key by just taking baby steps. Remember that? How to eat an elephant? One step at a time. Baby steps. Maybe it's growing a few edible plants in your windowsill. Just start a tiny aquaponic system. Put in a solar panel. Go ride your bike. Start doing more sharing when you're driving around. Go stay at an Airbnb. Use something like Uber or Lyft. Recycle, reuse, all kinds of ideas. Again, start small, grow big. Network with others with similar interests because there's so much power in collaboration. See how all these keys fit together? That's a Scrabble puzzle there, and it's important you get things to fit together. Remember key number three, the power of five. These things all link together. And as Nike says, just do it. Excuses are like armpits. We all have two of them, and they both stink. So that's kind of the end of the little bit of teaching here. I went about exactly the amount of time that I'd said, about 35 minutes. Here's the big takeaway. Don't procrastinate. Start today. Nike has this famous logo, just do it. But what you don't see sometimes is what's up above that. Yesterday, you said tomorrow. So this is a great lead into just a short pitch that I told you that we were going to do as we started out today. It says that some people have lost a little. Put in some ones if you're still hearing me all right, because Sheila said that maybe she lost contact. I bet it's your system. But if you got something out of this, do you mind if I just talk for about 10 minutes about something that's available for you right now through the Ecolonomic Action Team? Just throw some ones in. All right. Thank you. Phil's saying yes. David, Ann, thanks. Okay. I'm going to move ahead here. Just take a few minutes. Oh, I'm going to make what I call a big promise. Okay. I will guarantee you that if you become a lifetime member of the elite community today, you'll become healthier, happier, and be making the planet better in less than 30 days, or I'll refund your cost. A big promise. And you'll be living those five keys. So back in 2009, when I started to lead the Institute of Ecolonomics, a lot of people will say, this is through my life, this has been the case, that I'm like a squirrel in a pumpkin patch, always chasing the big dreams and ideas with no idea of how to make them work. You know, we had some pretty big floods. And I use this slide. This is our property, which is pretty nice looking, even on a crummy day like you're seeing here in this picture. That stream that you're seeing right there, usually that's probably 100 times more flow, or not maybe 120 times more flow than's normal through there. And there's a whole series of ponds. And as you look down there, it looks like it's all one. That's about a half mile down to the gazebo. You can kind of see right below the F on the word flooded. But it was a good slide to show because it shows that I tend to live a life where I'm always flooded with ideas and opportunities. It's not bad, but it can be distracting. So in May of this year, May of 2016, I decided to find a very simple thing, to do a very simple thing. Find world experts on economic topics and ask them to teach a 1 hour a week class about their passions. This Dr. Seuss thing over here, by the way, is pretty typical of what at least I believe about the world and about myself and whatever. So just read that if you would. I'm going to talk for just a minute on this. So we started in May, and literally just two of us, Mark Shepard and I, started teaching classes. And I'd teach for 1 hour on Mondays, and he'd teach for an hour on Wednesdays. Some of you were around then. And a couple weeks later, we had another teacher that came in to teach, Sarah Meyer, started to teach about how to raise pasture-raised natural pasture-raised chickens. Mike Warren started to teach topics and had speakers come in and teach about alternative health. And by the end of the summer, we were doing probably 6 hours a week or so of different special presentations by teachers who were doers that were teaching about their passions. Today, fast forwarding, we're up to where this week there'll be 12 different presentations, most of them more than an hour, about topics that are people's passions. And we've just continued that. Now, I've told this before, and you can read about it other places. This is not brand new. We actually copied something that's done in the internet marketing space. It's called OMG, One Man Gang, where they do that same thing. They've been doing it for 4 years, and they have over 4,000 hours of historic teaching that they've done, and they have about 30 hours a week that they teach. So we're up to about a third of that, and we're moving farther and farther towards it. 7 months, and we're close to 8 months now, we have almost 7,000 people who have chosen to become members of this Economic Action Team. We started out where it was free for everyone, and we said it's not going to be that way forever. As a matter of fact, when we reach 1,500 members, we said that from day one, we're going to start to charge for this because there's a whole bunch of work to do. We've got all kinds. There's just a ton of things that we have to do to make this work. And we said, once we reach that point, we're going to start to charge. Well, it was obvious we were going to reach that point sometime in September. And we finally set a date. We said by October 15th, we're going to start, charging. Well, we reached 2,500 members by that time. So there's a bunch of you that are probably on this that are what we call founders members of the Economic Action Team. And you don't ever have to pay anything. You're going to get value for as long as we're around. But some of you weren't there during that group. And we said we're going to start to charge following that time. And we also said you have to be somewhat active. We actually had a number of those initial 2,500 that never even took advantage of it. And we said if you didn't either show up for a live webinar, you didn't come to a replay, you didn't participate in our networking that we do on Facebook, then we'll turn you back into a free member rather than an active one. And I would bet of that 2,500, at least half are ones that we've actually brought and taken it back to the free level that we have, just because they weren't active and they really just didn't care. By the way, I haven't had anybody complain about that. So that's kind of where we're at now. I want to just tell you what a few of them have had to say about that and their experience with the. There's Nick Kudnick, who's in Maryland in the U.S. Nick has said, thank you so much for the opportunity to learn and be involved in such a noble project. By the way, I could give you hundreds of these. There's Bryant Redhawk, also from the U.S. Absolutely one of the best and most comprehensive presentations on operating a small farm, the economics of it, and how to scale production I've ever seen. Bravo. Marvin Weber. Marvin, I think, might be on here today from Canada, says, thank you so much, Wayne, and all the presenters. This is the most information-rich group that I know about, online or offline. I really appreciate being a part of EAT. I recommend lifetime membership in this group for anyone who wants to learn to be productive and profitable in agriculture, or even simply homesteading or making a living from the land. I look at that picture, which is one of his profiles, and see that amazing group of people, his family, I'm assuming, and know that he made this statement. And that's all it takes. We don't ever have to have another member of this group. And if all we do is touch Marvin, we've had some success. But I think we're touching a few more people. From Spade. Thanks for the invite, Wayne. Looking forward to learning from like-minded people. Thanks for giving us this fabulous opportunity to collectively make a difference. By the way, Leslie, you're on here. I know that picture. I don't know where I got that. I did something from around your area, and I thought I would get something that would be more indicative. I don't think that's a barn that Leslie has on her property. Valerie Jordana from Poland. Thanks for the admission and for the immense knowledge base that you provide on your website. Keep up the good work, guys. Lynn Powell in Canada. I really enjoy being a part of this site. It's a site that is focusing on teaching people about living sustainably and healthy. I'm learning so much about, well, so many things. And again, I could go on with hundreds of more. So here I'm going to tell you about what this special offer. So we've got something really special today. You can become a member today as a lifetime elite member of the Economic Action Team. And I've already talked about some of this, but to make this fast, you're going to get instant access. I mean, as soon as you become a member, to over 200 hours. It's actually closer. It's getting close to 300 hours now. It grows 15 to 20 hours a week, by the way, of training and networking with teaching, coaching, mentoring of world-class doer coaches with expertise in a broad array of subject areas. And it's growing. We're going to have more over time. Come on, slide, move. And these are core authorities. I already talked about Mark a little bit, but are amazing. And here's some of the names. William Horvath in Croatia, who teaches us about permaculture. And he teaches on a series every other week. Hugh Goebel, who teaches opposite weeks to William about business and financial planning. Hugh is a lifelong farmer, but also is an amazing teacher for business and financial planning. Dr. Herbert Warren from the U.S., who's the world expert in immune systems. And he leads up, and his son, Mike, lead up a series on alternative health and kinds of life. Evan Folds from North Carolina, who teaches on soil and fertility and bioenergetics. Amazing series that he's doing on a weekly basis. Myself and some of the things that I teach about, and you've been hearing me here for a time. So I teach about all kinds of different things that have been expertise, things that I've done in my life. None of these people, by the way, are teaching about something that because they like to and they went to college about it, they do these things day to day. By the way, no pitching, none of these offers, nothing like this in these teaching. It is teaching, hour long of teaching and then questions and answers and other interactions. Talked about this guy, if you don't know the name, he is Mr. Restoration Agriculture. He is literally the world leader. He wrote the book and many more. Also, you're going to get 10 to 15 hours of live. So I was talking about replays there, but live, you can come onto these. Now, by the way, you can get this just by coming to this webinar, this piece, but you can't get that last piece. You're not going to get all that accumulated information for just being a free member of our team. All of you are now going to be free members of the team. I've had several younger people, younger in age, that I've talked to, and so what I'm going to say now, several of them, they might be on today, have said what they get in the 10 to 15 hours per week of this live coaching is more than they would get in $12,000 per semester in a college setting. I don't know how many of you are recent college graduates. Some of you might be. If you are, tell me much how much help you're getting right now from those professors at your college to get a job. How much of them are they teaching you to form a business yourself? How many of those grad school advisors are meeting with you on a regular basis and being willing to talk to you weekly about your career and about your job? It used to be we got that. When I was in college many years ago, that's what happened. That doesn't happen anymore. We're making it happen in this community. I'm at Q&A sessions every week where you can be with these experts and others. We literally go through projects that we're going to work on and help each other with from all over the world. We have detailed plans and templates from our teacher coaches on topics about which they're teaching. Mark Shepherd recently gave an assignment that if you do that assignment, you're going to save yourself as much as dollars that you pay to other people to understand how you can better design a plan for your property to make it sustainable and regenerative and economic. Maybe the most important piece here is a network. And a bunch of the people that are on this webinar today are on here that are active members. I guarantee it, if you create a relationship, and I'm going to throw some names out, and they're just on the screen right now, with Alyssa, with Leslie, with Sue, with Ray, you're going to have your life totally enhanced. You're going to be around. I don't know, that was four names. I'll find, pick another one out. Nick, if you get around those five people, you're going to be amazingly enhanced in your life. Be able to download video and audio from all those hundreds of hours growing weekly of teaching presentations so you can listen to them or watch them at your leisure without internet access. There's going to be live events. We've already had one. We've now scheduled our second one. It's going to be late in February or early, actually. Haven't got the exact date. It's probably going to be early March in Southern California, out in the Palm Desert area, out at a farm that we have out there that's within our team. And it's a place where moringa is growing, where there's a shrimp production operation, where there's aquaculture going on. There's a camping area there. That's where we're going to have our next live event. We had one in the fall here at my ranch, and I think there are several people on that were at that. These are for members of our community. And then you get access to an exclusive secret Facebook group. This is that mastermind kind of situation I talked about. It's not available to the public. You can't get into it. You can't even know that it's there. There's no chance for trolls or anybody coming into it. That's just for our group. And it's like the old saying, what happens in Las Vegas stays in Las Vegas. And this is what happens. This would normally be valued. This whole thing would be valued at about $10,000. So then I'm going to tell you about some bonuses that you're going to get if you join this today. We haven't ever offered this before, by the way. And by the way, everybody on this call that is a lifetime member, and those of you that are on know what those are. If you are a lifetime member and the founders and lifetime members, if you're a founders member, you're a lifetime member, you're going to get these bonuses too, just because you took the time to be on this webinar. I told you guys there would be special bonuses for you. So you're going to see four bonuses here that you are all going to have. You just have to email me and tell me that you want to take advantage of them. Here's one we've never offered, and we probably will never offer this again. You can add a partner, somebody else, to be an elite member, lifetime member, just for you buying the membership yourself. So here's what you could do with that. Just be a separate member. They get unique logins and unique identities. So you just give it to a friend if you want it. Or maybe you could give it away as a present or provide it. Here's what I would hope maybe you'd do. Provide it as a sponsored scholarship to one of our scholarship applicants. I hope you maybe don't do this other one, but you could sell it privately or you do it in any way you choose. But I want to talk about that scholarship for a minute. Some of you are on here today, and one thing I know you think, I can't pay $10,000. By the way, the cost is not going to be $10,000. I just said that was the value. I'm going to come to a price here in a little bit, a lot less than that. But you don't have to if you can't afford this. We don't want to stop anyone from getting involved. On the very first page of your Eat Free website is a scholarship application where you can apply and you can say, you know what, I want to be a member of this elite community, but I can't afford it. We are not going to turn anyone down because they can't afford it. Now, we can't just let anybody in, so we need to get other Scott. We need to get other sponsors. So you might decide maybe you want to offer this other membership. And because we're a 501c3 nonprofit here in the U.S., that's a tax deduction that you could tremendous. So by generously providing this free second membership as a scholarship, you'll be acknowledged as what we call an economic global protector. And in the U.S., you could receive or you would receive a tax deduction for that amount. And I guarantee it, you would be a hero in the prestigious EAT community. So what are you getting value-wise if you do this? Well, I just said the elite team is worth $10,000. By the way, we are upping the price on the elite community about every 2 months now, because it's worth way more than what we're charging for it. And then you're going to get the value of another member at $899 and bonus. You can have a priority position to be granted to be a guest presenter yourself. Now, some of you are going, I don't ever want to do anything live. Well, if you don't, no big deal. But some of you do. And some of you that don't even necessarily want to not right now should. And by doing it, you're going to get replays of it yourself. You could add it to your resume. It could be something amazing. And you're going to get a half an hour private coaching session from myself and Mark and others. And then Mark from Bangladesh, who's probably on here, and Rugby Arib, our helpers, are going to do a rehearsal session with you. You can have your voice out to the world, and then it can be recorded, and you can use it to help you market. We'll help you put it together for your own little project. It's what you need to get your economic business started. So we think that that's got about a $500 value. Three. This is maybe a big one for you. We're going to give you a free 1 hour private coaching session with any one of our teachers, Mark, myself, William, Hugh, Evan, Mike, any number of the others. You can discuss your own project, ask questions, make comments, do any of those things. We'll do this scheduling and for you, because some of these coaches have really busy schedules. If you want again with Mark Shepherd, by the way, you better take advantage of this right away, because he's going to be booked up. We've already got about 30 people that are already on his schedule. So again, that's got its own value. We think that's worth about $400. Finally, a fourth bonus. We're going to do a press release for you. And this is for you. These are, remember, we're hoping you're people that want to build businesses to make this planet better. So we're going to do a press release, and it's pretty special. You're going to just provide the basic information about whatever you want that to be on, new product or service, launching your business, event, announcing a Kickstarter, you name it, using simple template that we've got. You're going to get 3 or 4 backlinks, which are things that we're going to take people back to you as calls to action for whatever you're doing. This is huge, by the way. And your press release is going to be distributed over 3,500 major news services, including NBC, CBS, ABC. You will be able to say, me as seen on NBC, CBS, ABC, Fox. You've probably seen some of that before. You get to have that. There's normally over 1,000 of these that will publish your release. And maybe the most important thing here is within 24 hours of that release, you're going to be on the first page of Google for whatever search terms that you want for the things that we work this out for. This is a huge value, maybe not so much financially as you start to see it, but it's massive. And we've never offered it to anybody else. So if you added that up, that's about $12,000 in value. So what could it be worth to you? So let me just talk about a few things. What if you completed the forest ecology assignment that Mark gives in episode 24, or 27, excuse me, and you use that outcome to design your own farm? You would be saving $7,000 to $10,000. What if you use the advice that William's given in just the last 2 weeks on how you buy and plan your land? That could save you $5,000 to $50,000 in just buying your property. Build an ecological aquaculture pond system using the advice that I gave in a 15-week course that I did on ecological aquaculture. You could be making $10,000 a year from your own business. I make over $100,000 from mine. We'll teach you how to do that. And then what if you use the advice that all of our alternative health coaches give and you don't get cancer? That's priceless. So again, just summarizing. Today, if we sold this to the public, we'd be selling that for $2,000, a little over $2,000. Why wouldn't you do that? Well, probably as you would, but I don't know that I can afford it. It's an investment, but I can't afford it. So we're going to even do a little better for all of you today. This is just for this webinar. We did one the other day, and we're doing this one now today. We'll another $1,000 off if you just do one thing. You promise to share your business or your economic success story with us just like these other people that I gave you some of the quotes from. And there's a whole bunch more that I could have put up there. Do that, and that you let us tell the world about your success story, just like we have some of the others that we shared today. It'll help you and it'll help everybody in the community. And we're going to give $1,000 more off for that just because of your willingness to do that. So I'm just quickly going through this. And then I'm going to just end by telling you some ways that you can do this. So again, special today is 1,053. So here's a ways you can do this. One, this is something that's only available in the US, and probably most of you have never even heard of this, but you could become a PayPal member. It's literally so simple. You could buy on PayPal, and you can, if you're qualified, and I haven't known anyone yet that hasn't gotten qualified, literally it happens within seconds after a click, and you can pay that amount and you get billed later. You have no payments for 6 months and no interest if you pay it off. Now, after that 6 months, they do charge interest. So if you're interested in that, you need to email me probably as soon as possible after this and tell me I'm interested in that. Or you can pay it in full. We have a real easy way to do that. Oops, I meant to put something up here, by the way. Sorry about that. I'm going to do something real quick. I'm going to put something up on the screen now. Should have done this a little bit ago. Deb, you should have reminded me of this. This is one of the reasons we're using this. So this is something you can do right now. And you can either buy this for $1,053 right now, or you can use an easy pay play to get it for $397 that you pay today and two more payments. Now, there's several other ways you can do it, but you don't get all the bonuses. We have a 14-day free to check this out. And then after that, you get billed for $75 a month for 12 months. So if you do that math, that's $900. Well, you get none of these bonuses, however. That will not make you eligible for these bonuses. Another way you can do it is to pay, $750 all at once, and you become a lifetime member, but you're not going to get all these bonuses. These are only being offered for people that are interested in becoming involved in this special offer today. Oops, gonna move over here. And then last thing, and then I'm done. I'm gonna open up to questions, is there's no questions asked. We have a full 30-day refund. If you're unhappy for any reason, you get your money back. I said that earlier with my big promise. If this doesn't work for you, we'll give you your money back. Again, one more thing. The first 15 or 20, I don't have an exact number, and we've got some that have already done this, but that take this offer, and it's not additional cost, are gonna be something kind of special. You're gonna get to come to our place, Deb's in my place here in the Rocky Mountains, the EAT headquarters, and spend some time with us. Once in a lifetime deal for you. And I wouldn't do it this time of the year. Wait till the spring or summer. And here's what you're going to get. We're not going to pay for your travel costs, but if you fly in, we'll pick you up at the airport and we'll return you there. So you don't have to worry about any of that. And then everything while you're here is on us. You're going to stay with us. You're going to stay in a private suite that we have. Again, I told you earlier, we don't live in a big mansion anymore. We used to, but we live in a pretty nice place. You'll have a private suite. You'll have all your own amenities. You're going to get served a home-cooked breakfast and dinner, probably get some home-cooked all kinds of stuff that we've made here at the farm and other things. Deb's an amazing cook. You'll spend that. You're going to hang with us for the day, and you can ask me and Deb any question you want. It's your day. You're with us, and you can watch us as we're doing our business things and whatever. It is literally something special. You can stay longer if you want. We have a cost. We do have people that stay here as Airbnb and so on, but you can stay longer and we'll reduce the price for a longer stay, but it's a one full day. So again, just to summarize, here's what we talked about. And I'm not gonna go into a whole lot more on that. And it is Q&A time. So I'm gonna put the chat box up on my computer here. So questions, Q&A for you guys. What kinds of questions? All about what I talked about in the teaching and anything about this offer that I just gave. Throw them out. Bunch of you out there. So throw the questions in. Let me just see. Deb, were there ones that I missed? So let me go down and look and see what might have come across as questions earlier. I don't see questions. Lots of comments, lots of cool dialogue that you guys are having with each other. So Mary asks, and I'll get to this one. It's a great question. What do you think the group will be doing in 1, 3, and 5 years from now? Thank you. That's a great question. First place, I didn't talk about some of the other things that the Institute of Ecolonomics is doing, which is what my big dream is that this team will lead towards. And I briefly talked about them, and I said the idea, plan, and hope for the hopeless, and best for the best. So that's what I want to talk about just a little bit now, because that's what I really hope. And I really believe, even in a year, that this team is going to be involved in, and certainly in 3 to 5 years. So let me talk about some numbers first. I think this team will be 20,000 members strong. We're at 7,000 now, and we'll be at 20,000 before we reach our first anniversary. So by the 1st of June. In 3 years, I think we'll be at 100,000, maybe more. And in 5 years, way over 1 million. That's, I firmly, with all of my heart, believe that. That's numbers. More importantly, these other things. I think you and you guys that are our members, remember, all of you are going to be members just by registering into the free community now. You're going to be doing things together. And there's going to be, by June, 4 to 10, that's a big range, but 4 to 10 businesses that get created that are collaborations of people on this team. And those businesses wouldn't have happened unless you guys worked together. You would have formed, let's say, one around TROPS, which are a water system that Nick is excited about. Ray is going to be moving her business and her passion to helping people that are a little bit older see that they can do life. There's so much more that they can do moving ahead. David Speakman, who I didn't see that's on here today, who's got a farm in Uganda, that he's literally, because of this group, he's taken, because of Mark's assignment in this group, he's taking money that he doesn't necessarily have right now. He lives in London, and he's going to Uganda to his farm that he has there, because in the very near term, as we create a group around him that will support him, he and his wife are going to move back there so they can create that as an ecolonomic center in Uganda, for people to be able to come to for all over Africa and other places. And that phone ringing, I'll ignore that in the background there. Sorry about that. I thought we'd turned that off.
From Force Cullen, CEO.
I wish that wasn't ringing. It is bothering me right now. Deb, could you please turn that off? Sorry about that. As you all know, I'm getting a call from Fort Collins, CO. That's Fort Collins is just up the road from us. It's probably one of my daughters, actually. At least two of them have got addresses up that way. Here's the most important thing, and I didn't talk about this, hope for the hopeless. I think a bunch of you, a bunch of this team is going to do something that we're doing. We're already doing it, but we're going to do it in a much bigger way. And that is, from my story that I gave, we're going to teach people to feed themselves in places in the world where right now they're either starving, and there are 1 billion people starving right now. As we're talking, 1 billion people are starving, or that are malnourished, which there are billions. It's probably half the planet that's malnourished. They think their food comes out of boxes. They don't know what cows are in terms of what they do. They've seen them maybe. You get milk from them? I could give some stories about me as a city kid earlier, and I literally thought that bulls produced milk because my cousins, who were farmers, produced ice cream, that the cows produced milk and the bulls produced ice cream. And I believed that for about 2 minutes, but that's kind of what they said, and they were the farmers, and they were pulling my leg, but that's what I believed. We're going to teach people to feed themselves. We are starting projects. We have 5 of them that are already in action. One in Mexico is probably the best, where we're going to send people out for as long as 1 year, 2 years, 5 years to teach people in their cultures whatever the best thing is for them to grow food and to feed themselves and to make money. That doesn't mean wheat in Swaziland. It doesn't mean corn in El Salvador. It means whatever's appropriate for there, what works there. And we're not just going to send somebody there for a 10-day experience and build a greenhouse or plow a field. We're going to commit to have people there for 5 years, 10 years, 25 years if we need to. And sometimes it might take a generation till the 5-year-olds that were there become 20-year-olds and now they're able to do what they've been learning for their whole lives. That's teaching people to fish that the man from Ghana was talking about. So that's going to be the goal in 1 year, 3 years, 5 years that we have that going. And that this community becomes the leading place in the world for people to hang out, to be with amazing teachers, and to be with amazing other business people to build their businesses. And then the last thing, and I truly believe this, we're going to be the new paradigm. And that's a big word about doing something in a completely different way to achieve a similar solution. And this education. We're going to be the place where you hang out instead of going to graduate school, for example, because you want to get a job and you don't want to be $50,000 in debt when you finish doing what you're doing. And maybe even more importantly, you want to start your own business. So that's what we want. We want people to become members here so they can make lives for themselves and not get themselves in so much debt that they can't get out of it. That's going to be the goal. That's the big goal for 3 to 5 years. So Deb says, Julian has a question about telling someone about this and who may purchase. Well, we're going to have potentially a replay. I said earlier, I mean, hopefully it works out. The offer's open. That this particular offer, this lifetime and with all these bonuses, is only going to be open for a limited time. If you tell them about it and get them to the replay, if we have one, and I think we probably will, then that's the way that you can get them to be able to see it. So I'll go ahead and the replay, I'm sure, I know what'll happen is if the replay happens, which it almost always does, but I can't promise it, you'll get a notice of it. All of you will soon after, and you can share that link with someone else. What else? What other questions? Are you offering the day with you guys to those that are already founding members? No, that was a special offer just for those that are earlier adopters of this. However, that's not formal. You guys want to come and stay with us. Those of you that are members, yeah, you can come up. And if you want to schedule that, and we'll absolutely find you a place to stay and here with us, and we'll take. But the real special one, that's offered to just the new people that are coming. But all the other bonuses are for you. Can we start a project to get the U.S. to openly, I think you maybe mean open, BLM land or permaculture homesteading? I'm thinking about inner city, Chicago, Detroit, who have no prospects in the city. Why BLM? You come to my place. You can come and homestead here. You can come. There's lots of places. It doesn't have to be BLM land. What our big goal is going to be is to get private people like me that'll open our places up to people just like that. And we're going to have hundreds of those around the world. David, if you're on here, would you offer somebody that in Uganda for your place? I'm going to really put somebody in line. Leslie, you're out there. Could somebody eventually, when you get things going, would you offer that they could come and become a farmer on your place in Missouri and potentially learn how to become and develop a permaculture homesteading kind of situation? I bet she would. I'm speaking for her. I shouldn't be. But that's what we all want to be doing. It doesn't take BLM land. We don't have to get the BLM to do this. But we certainly could start and be talking to them. I actually do have some connections, but that's... So anyway, don't apologize for leaving, by the way, anybody. I told people there's one more. We're finished with the presentation. The other bonus is I'm going to make the slides available from this to everybody that was on it. So you'll get all the slides. You can use those for yourself or with others. And another one is there's a book that some of you already have, but it's called Unleash the Entrepreneur Within You that I wrote several years ago. We've been using it for some other programs that we have, and we're going to give that all to you also. So again, thanks. Don't apologize for leaving. We're in the kind of extra time for Q&A. I'm going to hang right here as long as people have questions. If you don't have any more, then we'll stop at that point. So thanks everybody that's come to this point, and you guys have a great day. But if you've got any more questions, put them up on the chat and we'll answer them. Still a bunch of you out there, so if you've got them, throw them up there. Oh yeah, absolutely. All the coaching with Mark is available to founding members. If you're a founding member, everything is available. I don't think we've probably articulated that as well as we should. Founding members, you don't get the bonuses that we just talked about here, but everything that is in the founder lifetime, which is all the stuff on the website, all the teaching with Mark, the assignment for Mark, what the value you're going to get out of that, assignments that others of us are going to give, all of that's available. Mark, you're here. I don't know how long you've been on. John Paul says, thank you for your time. Always appreciate it. Thank you so much for being here, man. Any other questions from you guys? Is the coaching for an hour? Maybe if that was your question, Jess, no, that's not available. It is for you on this webinar. That's what I said. Those extra bonuses is available for you because if you're a founding member and you're on here, if you're not a member at all, or if you're a free member, I want to make sure I get that. You just send me an email, Jess, and that's the way that you get that. It's that simple. Michael says, Wayne, I'm already a lifetime member. What is your email address? It's, if you're a lifetime member and you haven't been to the site, it's all over it. It's put it on the chat, Mark or Deb. It's and I have two of them. It's waynedorband@gmail.com or wayne@ecolonomics.org. Either one of those. But it's all over every announcement that you ever get and all the other stuff. So it's probably as visible as anything you could find. Mary, a lot of BLM is going to desert. Oh yeah, it needs huge upgrade. I absolutely know it. And we should all be working to try to improve stuff that's going on BLM. Whether we can get them to open it up for more homesteading, I'm not sure of that, but certainly worth trying. You know what? That's one of those big dreams. Mary, you take that as your big dream and you get us all engaged in it. So John Paul, thanks for putting that on there. Can one link a PDC program or a permaculture group to the elite membership? If you mean could any of us teach a PDC? Yeah, absolutely, we could. There are so many people teaching PDCs. We don't need to go out and copy what a lot of other people are doing. We formed this because nobody else is doing this. This is unique. There's not another community like this out in the sustainable, regenerative, restorative, all those adjectives, ecolonomic world. There isn't one. Another one, Sam, is we'll be, by a year, we'll have 30 hours a week of live presentations. In 5 years, we'll be around the clock. It'll be like a TV network, or used to be. You'll be able to watch any time you want, 24 hours a day, live presentations from leaders, from the best in the world. If you're already Elite Founders members, you're all you got to do is tell me you're ready for them, Alec. And that's the way it. It's people that were attending these webinars that are going to get those benefits. So we've got you're on a list, Alec, all the registrants and attendees that are here will know who you are. So if you were here, you're going to get them, all of those benefits. So we'll be contacting you and telling you how you get them. Is there an ongoing? Yes. every Monday night, Ben, at you guys help me if I get the time wrong, 7:15 Mountain. We have a very intimate group, and sometimes it's 7 people, sometimes 20, and we get huge intimacy and get questions on all the time. And that if we can't answer them then, if we have to go to Mark or to Evan or to William, if they're not on, we get it to them then. And then every one of our live sessions, I don't think any question that's ever been asked on a live session hasn't been answered. And Ben, Alyssa just said it there too. If you become a member and you get to our secret Facebook group, Again, that's Las Vegas. That's it. What happens there stays there, but we answer very intimate questions there. Jess says, I'm a landowner and host other farmers, homesteaders, but my local farming doesn't allow it. Yeah, that's a great question. Are you sure that it doesn't? So here's why I'm saying that. Check with like your state regulations. If you're ag zoned, and if you're actively involved in farming, so you're truly determined by whatever your local jurisdiction's farming, most ag zoning in the US does allow housing for anyone doing ag work. And it's kind of a loophole. But maybe if you want to talk privately about it, there are some other things that we could help with. But that's just one thing. So a lot of people don't realize that here in Colorado and several other states that I know of, they had to really check the rules, but found that that was a possibility. So that's something to think about. Mark says, I know a person living in Benin who could hugely benefit from being a partner that I could add to this group. How much time do I have to get them connected and how do I do that? First place, the group's open all the time. And this is just this special offer that we have that's for 7 days following the webinar, that during the 7 days after this is when this all those bonuses are out there. But you can certainly give them the link to the replay. You can, Deb, put it up in the chat. Just give them the link to the site, www.eatcommunity.com. And they can become a free member there if they want to put a scholarship application in. If they want to become a lifetime member, the Gekka said there's like five other options and ways that people can do that there. Or if you want, just send me an email and I can help you figure out how to get them in front of it. We're not shutting down the community, that's for sure. As a matter of fact, I'm doing 4 different live presentations to outside groups. We are just now starting to really market this community. There's going to be Facebook ads about this webinar and the replays of it and other. We're going to be doing more and more promotion and we're going to be special guests. I'm going to be on the panel of 3 different live summits that are coming up in the near future. And my role there and my goal there is to promote EAT. So that's going to be what we're doing on the marketing side. We want you to make money as affiliates too. Bring in other people. We've had almost 500 of our free members that have come in just because people in the community who we give affiliate status to have brought them in. And several of those are now going from their free status to be paid members. And as paid members, you make 50% if you're the affiliate that brings them in. So somebody starts coming in at $75 a month, you would get $37.50 every month for that. If somebody buys our elite program for the one-time pay of $750, you get $375, whatever that half of that is, half of that, $375, I think is the right number for that. So there's money you can make, and that's the whole goal here, is that we all have to be developing some kind of profit from what we do economically. Leslie says the same loophole in Spain is 4 hectares. Yeah, we need to talk about, because I think if there are loopholes in a lot of the regs in various different places, as long as people are not considered completely outsiders on the property. But anyway, Stephen says, I made it extremely late. Is there a way I can find out what the bonuses are without having to explain it? Yeah, again, I think there'll be a replay. I hope there will. And you're going to get all of the slides after this, Stephen, that will have them on it also. So, but again, the bonuses, there were 4 of them. One of them is you actually get a second membership that you can either give to someone. You can give it as a scholarship if you'd like, so which you'd get a tax donation here in the United States. I think you'd probably get a tax donation in other places in the world also. There is a free coaching session with one of our teachers for an hour, which is a $500 or $600 value for a lot of these guys. There's a press release that we're going to do. For really early adopters, there's going to be a stay with Deb and I here at our ranch. There is a potential to come on, or not potential, you can if you want, come on and do presentations on the community yourself, to do one which will promote your business and what your expertise is. But those will be available. We get those in the slides. Can I promote EAT in the profile for my crowdfunding? Absolutely. Oh, yeah. And we can, Leslie, we need to talk about that. That ought to be something that we make as a benefit as in your crowdfunding, to where that's part of what your donative values are for people as they're providing whatever the amount is that you're thinking about for each of your levels of crowdfunding. So we ought to make that bonuses. So that's something that should be really helpful for you. What else? You guys are still throwing it. By the way, there's about a 12-second delay from when I'm talking live, from when I see things. You guys are seeing it like 12 seconds later. So your questions come about 12 seconds after I kind of ask for them. Mark, you've been so amazing as a guest here. Thank you. Thanks for coming. You spent your time here also, not just mine. Yeah, crowdfunding. You ought to think about crowdfunding. We're going to do some teaching on that. The new Webinar Jam software, audio and video, are a great improvement. Maybe they are for you now. I'm not sure what they would be for GoToWebinar, over GoToWebinar and other settings. But if it turns out this is a better place, we'll come and do our teaching on this also. We're not tied to GoToWebinar in any way. I think Mark is kind of talking to Jess. The chat, by the way, will be available for this afterwards. So if it works and the replay works, which I hope it does, that's been one of the problems. Some people in the past, there's been Webinar Jam, people have had trouble with their replays. We have never had a problem, not once in 270 some hours, using GoToWebinar. So I'll just hang for just a second here to see, because you guys are still out there, see if there's other questions. If you like this, maybe throw some ones up. Just say that it had some value to you guys if you want. And then there's still a bunch of you out there. So I'm just kind of waiting and seeing if you any of the other. If you don't, we'll jump off here pretty quickly. Usually on push during the week when we're doing our teaching webinars, we've got one right after another, and we all spend time prepping for them, those of us that are teaching. And so we've always got more that we've got to work on. Yeah, that's one. You're right, Mary. It doesn't work as well. That's the other. Mary's saying about GoToWebinar versus this. One of the reasons we really like GoToWebinar is you can actually just use a telephone number from anywhere in the world to call into it free. As our speakers can and other, you can't do that on this. You'd have to kind of indirectly get in that way on this. We're going to actually start doing more things on Facebook Live too. We've done a couple of examples of that. We did one last week. We'll probably do two or three this week. We'll present those inside the groups, either in the Eat Free group. We'll probably put them there. That's where you'll be able to watch them on Facebook Live also. Did you guys learn something from the teaching? Forget about the offer. Did you learn, and are you going to take something away? Whoever's left here, put something up there that, yeah, yes, I'm going to do one of those things you talked about in those five keys. Something. Just say, yes, I'm going to do that. That would be really make me feel like at least something of value, because I really feel strongly about all those things, that those five keys. By the way, I don't know what the video quality you're seeing, this image quality is, but this is a lot better than what it is on GoToWebinar. I will tell you that, at least from what I'm seeing. But who needs to see my face? It's not that important. Mary says she's going to use all of them, several of them. Well, yes, probably several of them. Cool. All right. Well, I'm not seeing other questions. And again, I hope they'll get the replay done for this. Hopefully that works well. And you guys are awesome. Thank you for coming. Tell everybody else about the Economic Action Team if this is at all meaningful for you. And we'll see a bunch of you over this next week on our teaching. There'll be another, you'll get an announcement tomorrow night, and there'll be 10, 12, 15 hours of teaching this next week. Try to go to Nick Burton's State of the Soil and see that. It'll be all day long also. Thank you, everybody. I'm going to be signing off. Bye.